All right, so today we're gonna make a program that does a little game. Oops, there it is. All right, so it runs around like this. We've got our little cursor here, which is in black. We can move it around with the arrow keys. The little red things are food. We're supposed to eat all those by moving over to them, and then the blue are ghosts. We try to avoid those. Those are the enemies. If they touch us, we die. So if we hit the food, we eat it up. If we hit a ghost, then we die and we lose. If we hit the wall, then we die. In the top wall, we also die. Okay, so the goal is, let's see if I can do it. We gotta eat all the red food before the blue ghosts get us. Now they're just moving around in a random order. They're not chasing me or anything. I haven't done that yet. See if I can get this. Oh, that was close. This one and that one. And all that text on the screen is just scrolling out because I have a bunch of output. All right, and that's it. Game's over. We won. Okay, that's how it works. All right, so that's what we're gonna do. Oops. All right, so to do this, the first thing the tool we're gonna use, we're gonna do this in C++, and we're gonna use a library called xlib, or I'm sorry, yeah, xlib and X11. So X11 is the way you draw graphics to create a window, basic Windows graphics in Linux. Okay, so right now, we're gonna make a development directory. That's where we're gonna start coding in. It's completely empty. So the first thing we need to do is create a main CPP. So we'll just do vim, and that will open a new main. If you're not familiar with vim, I'll have another video on vim, but it's a text editor that runs in the terminal window. So here's vim. All right, the world's most basic program, int main. And we'll return 0. Okay, there's main. We need to create a CMake list file because we're going to use CMake for this. If you're not familiar with CMake, I'll have other videos on CMake. Three lines. CMake minimum required. We give it a version for CMake 3.10. So that means this is written to be compatible with CMake version 3.10 or later. We need a project name. I'm just going to call it X11 game, and then we need to create an executable or a library. In this case, we're going to create an executable because it's a program we want. So we give it a name. Let's call it X11 game, and then we need to give it source files, which is just main CPP. That's it. So we write and quit. There's our two files. You can use cat on the command line, which means catalog, to see what the contents of the file are. So CMake list, we can see that's what's in CMakeList.txt. We can do cat main, and that's what's in main. Great. Now we need to build it. So we'll make a build directory, make directory build. There's our build directory. Go into build, call CMake of dot dot, which is the parent directory, and that runs CMake. It's looking for a CMakeList.txt file. That's what we're using. So now CMake has generated all these files. In particular, it's created a make file. So when we call make, it's going to read the make file and run all the commands in there. And now we've created our game, X11 game, and the name here is the same as the name that we gave the executable name right here. Our project and the executable happen to have the same name, but it's using this one. This is the name of the target. Okay, to run it, dot slash, which means this directory, or the current directory slash, and then the name X11 game. Okay, so nothing happened as expected, but there's our first basic program. All right, so the next thing we want to do is start adding the code to show a window. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead and we're going to include X11 xlib so that we can show the window. And we're also going to include, man, if only I could type. Oops. standard IO, so we can use printf. All right. First thing we need is to create a display pointer. So we're going to call it display pointer D. And we're going to call the function open display with no parent null. And then we need to check if that worked. So if D is equal to null, then we know it failed, because the pointer should be non-null if it worked. So we want to print some error, unable to open the display. And we'll go ahead and exit. Okay. Rebuild it. It says, oh no, there's a problem I can't find. It says, while using LD, which is the linker, running building main CPP object file in the function main, we have an undefined reference to X open display. Okay, let's just look at main. You can see that we have this function right here, X open display. It can't find where that function is. That's because we're not linking to the X11 library. It defines it, but it doesn't know where to find the actual code for the body of the function. So we need to link to it. To do that, we need to edit our CMakeList file. So we're going to add a couple lines. First is we're going to call find package X11. And that looks for where all the X11 header files and library object files are. And then we are going to include them by giving the directive target link libraries. And we need to give it the target, which in this case is the name of our executable, X11 game. That's what we called it, X11 game. You know what, to make this more explicit, I'm going to call this project so that we can tell the difference. X11 game is the target. That's the name of the executable itself. And then we're going to tell it to include X11 libraries. You wouldn't necessarily know this unless you look up for the library what the name is. So you have to look it up for each library you need to include. But they're usually something like the name of the library underscore libs or libraries, something along those lines. All right, so now let's go back to build and build it again. Okay, this time it worked. You can see it linked successfully. And it built the target X11 game. And there it is. So let's run it. Again, it does nothing, because all we did was get a pointer to a display, but we didn't actually do anything with it.